Welcome! I'm glad you made it. We're doing something a bit surreal today. We'll be learning how to do CRUD in SurrealQL through the story of Mr. Andersen. You ready? Let's go! To start off our story, we're going to create our hero. So here, we're creating the table hero and the record Mr. Andersen. Now the content of the record is the chosen one as a description and computer stuff as one of his skills. So if we enter that in, you can see that we've created an array and then an object within that array. And you'll see that the ID is made up of the table name and also the record name, what we call a record ID in SurrealDB. Now after this, we have a hero, but we also need a villain. And so I'm going to insert a villain here. So I'm directly inserting into a table that doesn't exist. And what happens is that SurrealDB will actually create this table for us. So we're going to create a table villain, the name and the description. The name will be Agent Smith, and he really hates Mr. Andersen. Now you'll see that the ID gets automatically generated, and you'll have the table and then a random string. And this is really important because a random ID is very helpful to increase security. It helps to reduce write contention at scale, especially across distributed clusters, and has many more benefits that we'll get onto later. But first, we want a few copies of Mr. Smith, because Mr. Smith is a lot of copies. And then we also want to have an ID that we'll use later. All right, now we got our ID and got our villain. We need the hero to have some more skills because he can't fight Agent Smith with just computer skills. He needs to learn Kung Fu. So we're going to update our hero, Mr. Andersen, and set the skill, and we're going to add the Kung Fu. And now the hero knows Kung Fu. All right, so now it's time for the big fight. We're going to make a relation, a join of sorts, from the hero, Mr. Andersen, and he fights, and here is where the villain ID is useful. So our hero, Mr. Andersen, fights the villain. And the content of that fight will be Agent Smith saying his iconic catchphrase. All right, when we create that, you notice that there was a fights table that was created. And we see the ID here, fights, and then the random ID. And we will also see the in, where the record came into the table and where the record goes out of the table. That kind of defines the relationships. And we can have more than one fight going on. All right, so how can we query this? So here we can actually see from the hero table and selecting Mr. Andersen, who is he actually fighting? We can see that here, this fight and then out, we're actually seeing, okay, Mr. Andersen actually goes into, so where's the out? So the out is the copies of Mr. Smith that we're looking for. Now we can query this in many different ways. We can see all the details of those fights, and we can also query it like so, and select the first fight, and then select the second fight. There are many more things about graphs that are really interesting that we'll cover a bit later, but let's focus now on the result of that fight. What happens? Well, what happens really is that the villain gets a link to Mr. Andersen. So here we're representing it. So we're updating the villain and we're updating all the villains in the villain table. And we're putting the content, the hero link, a link to this record ID. And so now you can see that every copy of Agent Smith has a link to Mr. Andersen. And this is a way, another way of joining them together. So we have looked at graph, and here we have record links. And we can query them like so. So I'm querying the villain table, but the fields I'm selecting are actually from the hero table through the hero link that we just defined. And here I'm selecting the skills. I'm selecting the Kung Fu skill. And here I'm also selecting the ID. Now, what is the ultimate result of this? So the fight has happened, and what happens? Well, the villain is deleted. So now we're going to delete all the records from the villain table where the name is Agent Smith. So that's done. But of course, we're afraid that Agent Smith might come back. And so what do we need to do? We actually need to completely remove the table. And so here we have removed the table. And with that, we have covered a simple CRUD example using the story of Mr. Andersen and Agent Smith. We have covered how to create tables. We have covered how to insert into tables, how to update, basics of using the relate to use graph joins. We've also used basics of querying it to update and record links and deleting and dropping. All right, that's all for today. You can check out more in our documentation and join our Discord channel. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.